There are so many people looking to switch their career path or simply looking for a side hustle that can help them make extra income from home. I've compiled 12 incredible, high-paying work-from-home side hustles that just about anyone with a laptop can do. In case you're new, I'm Sandra, and I figured out multiple ways to make income online, and I love to share my experience and advice on my channel. So if you haven't already, I would love for you to hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you get notified every time I post a new video. Some of these side hustles I'm mentioning today, I've done myself, so I can guarantee that you can make a pretty good income from them. Now, I do recommend you listen to all 12 before you consider one for yourself because they're all very different from each other. We're gonna go over how much you can expect to make from each option based on real life examples and how you can actually get started today. So let's jump right in. The first side hustle idea I have for you is a virtual assistant. VAs are incredibly high on demand because businesses are starting every single day and they need people to help them out with tasks that they just don't have time for. As a virtual assistant, you can expect to make at least $25 to $50 an hour depending on your skill sets and what you're helping your clients with. A great resource for you to check out and a place that you can actually post your services is Upwork. So all you have to do is go to the search bar and type in the occupation that you want to take on. So let's say a virtual assistant. You can scroll down and take a look at what people are charging, what they're offering, and it'll give you an idea of how much you should charge. The tasks you can expect to take on as a virtual assistant is administrative work, like scheduling appointments, organizing to-do lists, organizing calendars, creating and posting content on social media, and basically any task that your client needs off their plate so that they can focus on what they need to focus on to grow their business. A virtual assistant is the first role that I'm going to be looking to fill in my business, and guess where I'm going to look first? I'm gonna go to Instagram and go to accounts, and I'm going to search virtual assistant. Then I'm gonna scroll through and take a look at these people's accounts. I'm gonna see the content they're providing, maybe some testimonials that they've gotten from their clients, and I'm gonna reach out to the ones that I really like and ask for their rates. So to get started, it's as simple as creating an Instagram account, putting in a virtual assistant in your bio, and maybe reaching out to some small business owners that you can offer your services at a free or low rate in exchange for testimonials and experience for yourself. Number two is a social media manager. Now I do recommend that you only focus on one social media platform so that you can specialize in that and therefore charge more. At an intermediate level, you can expect to charge between $50 to $100 an hour, and I've seen people at an advanced level charging $200 plus per hour. Now it's because they're specialized in, for example, Instagram, Facebook, maybe YouTube channels, even Pinterest accounts. And as a manager, you would be creating and posting highly engaging content and reviewing the analytics to see what's actually driving the most traffic and results for your client. You could also be managing partnerships with other brands and responding to audiences' comments. If I wanted to be a social media manager, the first place I would go to is Facebook, and I would join Facebook groups that are specific to the social media platform that I want to gain expertise in and find clients. So for example, if I wanted to specialize in Instagram, I would go to the search bar and type in Instagram. You'll see here that I'm part of this massive Instagram Facebook group that has almost 95,000 members. How many people do you think are posting in there daily, whether they're asking tips and tricks on Instagram or specifically looking for a strategist to help them grow their Instagram account for their business? This is a place where you can start and nurture relationships with people that you can eventually take on as clients. Number three is coaching and consulting. This is where a lot of people struggle with imposter syndrome, thinking that they really have nothing to offer. But I'm gonna tell you right now that you don't necessarily have to be an expert at something. You just have to be a few steps ahead of your clients in order to help them get the results they're looking for. Now, the great thing is if you're offering one-on-one coaching packages, you're able to charge so much more. Think of a personal trainer. They're able to charge a lot more because it's very personalized and they're focusing on that one client and getting them the best results possible. possible. So for example, you could be offering a one-on-one coaching package for $2,000 to $2,500 per client, and therefore you only need 2 to 3 clients per month to hit a target of $5,000 per month. Now to get started, you want to be very clear on the target audience you're trying to attract and what you're helping them solve. Now of course, you can start by offering your first few clients lower rates so that you can get your feet wet, gain some experience, and get your clients results. Number 4 is a digital course creator. Now what you can do with your coaching program that you've put together, you can actually package that into a digital course that you sell over and over again. And this becomes evergreen for you and therefore passive income. The great thing about this business model is that you're able to scale it much more than one-on-one coaching. I do recommend you start with one-on-one or group coaching and then eventually package that into a course because you've already proven that your program works. I've personally paid for multiple digital courses. I've paid $1,000, $2,000 and above. And you'd be surprised on what people turn into a digital course and the topics they cover. There's literally a course on everything out there. So I promise what you are good at can be monetized. Now you can create your digital course on platforms like Kajabi, Thinkific, or Teachable. Number 5 is completely different than the last 4 that we've talked about, and that is drop shipping and print on demand. The thing about this one is it's a little bit more risky because it does require a little bit of investment on your end. Now, if you don't know what drop shipping and print on demand is, it's basically setting up a store where you sell physical products, but you don't have to store, package, or ship any of the products because a third party takes care of all of that for you. So what you would have to do is set up a store on Shopify, Amazon, or Etsy, for example. And when a customer purchases a physical product from you, it triggers the third party to package that product and ship it to their address, and you don't have to do anything. I do recommend that you invest in some samples from that third party to make sure that you are satisfied with the quality and you're keeping your customers happy. Now I'm gonna share my screen right now to show you an example of a platform you can get started on if this is what you're interested in, because it does eventually become passive income for you. So this is printful.com, an example of a third party that you can design your print on demand product, and when a customer purchases from you, Printful will take care of the rest. So what you could do here is go to products, and let's say for example, I want to create a t-shirt shop. I can go to women's clothing and go to t-shirts, and I can scroll through to see which one I want to design my graphics on. So let's say I go for this bestseller over here. You can see how many options there are. You can change the color of the t-shirt before you actually add any graphics. Let's go for white. And scroll down, go to start designing. This is where you can add your designs. So I can go to design and I can go to choose file. So if you've designed a file already and you've converted it to a JPEG or PNG file, this is where you can upload it. And you can see over here that you can also add a design on the back. If you need to watch tutorials on this, you can just go to video tutorials on exactly how this works and watch some more YouTube tutorials on how you would actually connect this to your website from people that are already experienced with this business model. If you're getting value from this video so far and it's inspiring you to start a side hustle or business working from home, be sure to give this video a like and let me know in the comments which option is standing out to you so far. Number 6 is one of my favorites and it shouldn't surprise you, and that is a YouTuber. As a relatively small and new YouTuber, I've been able to make anywhere between $1,200 to $1,600 a month, which I'll show a screenshot of my earnings from the last few months. And the great thing is, this is just from YouTube AdSense alone. I also use my YouTube channel to generate income from affiliate marketing, sell my own digital products, and I'm also considering brand sponsorships in the near future. So if you feel like you want to start a YouTube channel to share your message with the world, to educate people or entertain people, this would be a great way for you to make some side income in multiple ways passively. Now, I have a lot of experience with number 7, and that is a freelance graphic designer that is specialized. The reason I say specialized is because the more you can focus on one type of service as a graphic designer, the more you can charge. This is what my Instagram account used to look like when I was offering wedding stationery for brides-to-be. And because I was only focusing on weddings, I was able to charge more for my services. When the pandemic hit, I had to pivot my side hustle, and I decided to serve small business owners by creating logos and business cards for them. The great thing is, I was only getting clients from my friends, family, referrals, and Instagram alone. And I really didn't have to post my services anywhere else. But a great place that you can also get started on is Fiverr. So if I go on to Fiverr and I type in custom logo, I can get an idea of how much people are charging. Now, I would be a little bit careful on comparing yourself too much because a lot of people are charging, let's say, maybe $20 to $30 for a logo, but these are very simple, minimalist logos and they're only offering one or two revisions. It's okay to start with lower rates, but if you are specializing in, let's say, logos alone, you can charge up to $250 per logo with a few more revisions. And to increase the price per client, you can also upsell your clients and let them know that you're offering packages where you can design their logo, business card, postcard, thank you card, or whatever you can offer to be able to charge more for your package. All right, number 8 is a freelance video editor. Now, this may sound a little bit too technical if you're not really comfortable with video editing, but I learned how to edit all my videos on iMovie, and there are so many other alternatives, it doesn't have to be a Mac, that are very basic. And there are a lot of new creators on YouTube that need video editors like you. If you're not comfortable with editing videos, but that is something you're interested in, you can just watch YouTube videos and tutorials for free to get comfortable with it, because that's exactly what I did. Now, you can see here that people are charging up to $100 per hour, depending on your skill set and your expertise. Number 9 is virtual bookkeeping. If you have a background in finance and accounting, we all need you. This is a very stressful job and I would never do this on my own. I would definitely get a virtual bookkeeper as many other entrepreneurs need it. You can use online accounting software where your client will share all their financial information with you and you manage everything remotely from the comfort of your own home. It's definitely something that every entrepreneur would love to hand off to a professional and you can charge up to $100 an hour with this service. Number 10 is transcription services. So you would have to listen to voice recordings and convert them into written documents. If you haven't noticed, a lot of YouTube videos have subtitles available to the viewer, and they're using websites like rev.com or TranscribeMe to include subtitles in their videos. I checked the rates on how much you can expect to get paid here, and I found that TranscribeMe pays a little bit more, and they offer $15 to $22 an hour for transcribers. So if this is something you're interested in, all you have to do is go to TranscribeMe.com, go to jobs, and click on Get Started to apply. The 11th option I have for you is a copywriter. Now, I personally don't like writing. I'm really bad at writing blog posts. It takes forever for me to write emails, and a lot of entrepreneurs would love to get help from really good copywriters. So you can expect to write, like I mentioned, blog posts, emails, and even ads like Facebook ads that are compelling in order to get viewers to click on the ads. So if you enjoy writing, you can charge anywhere between $15 to $40 an hour as a copywriter, and of course you can post your services on Upwork, on LinkedIn, and on Instagram as a few examples. In this case, I would also recommend that you do specialize in one thing so that you can charge more. This way you'll be the go-to person for that specific area, and people will expect to see very specific results that you are promising them. And finally, number 12 is a really good one because you can charge a lot for this, and that is a web developer or website designer. My friend literally told me the other day that she was looking for rates for a very simple, basic website, and she was getting quoted $2,000. Which is fair. I created my super basic website on Squarespace and I watched free tutorials on YouTube on how to do it. This is something you can definitely learn from home on your laptop. And if you're charging $2,000 to $3,000 per client, you don't need that many clients per month to hit your targets. Of course, it would also help if you have some skills in keywords and SEO, so search engine optimization, in order to help your clients rank in Google. Keep in mind that it's really important that you build brand awareness around any one of these options that you choose, because you need to treat them like a real business that you want to nurture and build over time. These aren't get-rich-quick schemes. They take time, patience, and a lot of effort, but I promise you it pays off. You can watch this video next on passive income ideas starting from scratch, where I share screenshots of how I've been able to make $3,000 a month passively. Let me know in the comments which side hustle or business idea you're thinking of getting started on. Give this video a like if you found it helpful, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell for notifications every time I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye, guys.